Hey folks, I'm Dagan.
I'm Meg.
From PMTVUK, and today we have the pleasure of chatting about the specs and finding out if the Bose S1 Pro and L1 Pro all-in-one PA systems have what it takes to stand the test in 2023.
The Bose S1 Pro, if you're not too familiar already, is a battery-powered and super portable PA speaker with multiple channel inputs, a built-in mixer with some tonematch presets, and it's got Bluetooth connectivity, but we'll get a little bit more into that shortly.
Whereas the L1 Pro systems are line array systems, this is the L1 Pro 8. There's also the L1 Pro 16 with 16 drivers and the 32, which comes with a separate sub bass. We'll be putting these through the test today, as well as, like I say, talking about the specs. For any more information on these guys, they're all linked in the description box down below so you can check them out. But yeah, we'll be seeing what these PA systems, which have been around for a little while now and holding their own, but let's put them to the test and see if they can hold their own here in 2023.
Bose are a household name and they make everything from noise cancelling headphones, which I believe you have some.
Yes, I've got a set of those and I think you do as well.
I do.
Excellent.
All the way up to high quality, high end PA speakers and hi-fi systems. Bose are well known for their quality and clarity in their sound, and these speakers here are no different. So looking at the Bose S1 Pro first, this, as I said before, is a super portable and battery-powered PA speaker, which makes this one of the most versatile speakers in terms of where you can use it. It's got a built-in lithium-ion battery, which has up to 11 hours battery life, which is crazy. And if you were looking to use this anywhere outdoors, then this would definitely stand up, for instance, in a busking environment, or if you are taking it out for a jam, or even using it as a speaker for a party or something to stream music to. There's lots you can do with this system, and it's got two multi-channel inputs, so you can have a mic or instruments running through it, and it's got built-in tone match presets. If you're not familiar with what a tone match is, this is Bose's mixer, and on these mixers they have some really great quality presets for microphones and instruments. So this little speaker has that built in too, which can help you add a bit of extra pizzazz to your live sound. It's also got an aux in as well as the Bluetooth in for streaming, and you've got main volume, EQ and reverb on the two instrument channels. Having the reverb is a great way to lift your sound a bit if you are playing outside busking, for example, or even if you're just singing at a small cafe gig.
We hold out your hands for me like I would for you. Think for a while, please don't make.
But these speakers are not just limited to music. You could use them in a conference environment. You can even, if you want to, like I did with my friends at Christmas, use this as your speaker for karaoke at home. Get all your friends around and plug a microphone in. That's a lot of fun. For a small speaker, it's surprisingly loud too. It's got a 6-inch low frequency high excursion woofer, as well as three 2.25-inch high frequency drivers in it. So it can carry a surprising distance, and if you are using this for busking, you will be really surprised how far the sound can travel. So you can have this speaker in lots of different angles as well, which can really help your sound travel. For instance, you can have it on its side like this, which means you can have the sound traveling out, or if you wanted to, you could have it as your personal monitor on stage coming back at you. You can have it on a speaker stand, or you can have it upright angling out to the crowd so you get the best coverage of the sound coming out to the audience listening. There's lots you can do with these little speakers, and as you said, they have been around for a while, but I'm not surprised at all that they have been super popular over the years. I have one myself, and it's the perfect speaker to take out in a busking environment like I'm gonna do with it today. When it comes to the battery, all you need to do to charge it is plug it into the mains cable and leave it for a few hours till it flashes that it is full charge, and then you've got that 11 hours battery life to use with it. There's a few other neat features that come with this speaker as well. Because of the Bluetooth, you can connect it up to the Bose Connect app, which allows you to mess with the settings, but you can also, if you were using this as a speaker and you had a second unit, you can select party mode on your phone and this will lift the sound and allow you to connect too for a lot more volume if you are being the DJ at a party. And if you really want to personalize your speaker within the Bose Connect app, you can set up a name for your speaker and there seems to be an infinite list of names to choose from. So you can do that, and if people are searching for your speaker on Bluetooth, then your chosen name will come up.
What's ours again? The Aluminium Mistress.
Aluminium Mistress. With the wireless as well, there is up to 9 meters wireless range, which is great. So if you are controlling that music or streaming a track to it when you're playing live, then you've got quite a distance to go from before it will drop out. And lastly, as I mentioned, the tone match, if you did find that the inputs built into this aren't enough, then you can always get an external tone match and connect it to this to give yourself more inputs and even more control over the sound.
Moving on over to the Bose L1 Pro system, what I have with me today is the Bose L1 Pro 8. Due to the fact that it's got 8 5-centimeter neodymium drivers up top that deliver 180 degrees of horizontal coverage and a max SPL rating of 124 decibels. That's just numbers and letters though. The main thing about the L1 Pro line array systems that everyone enjoys is the fact that it's powerful, it's extremely clear, and it's utterly brilliant at being portable. Whether it be this, the L1 Pro 16 or the L1 Pro 32, the 32 though does come with a separate base, a separate sub, sorry. There's a sub 1 and the sub 2, which have racetrack drivers to make them very portable, but also still very powerful. With the 8 and the 16, it's built into the base of the unit itself, built into the base of the line array to give you that thump, but also be very sleek, stylish, and portable as well. It is quite imposing, the beautiful skinny speaker neck here, but to pull it apart and to set it up is super simple. It all just slides into itself. So you just carry them like this, and that's how easy it is to rock this guy at a gig. Now, my old band used to use these, and this sounded absolutely fantastic. I'm gonna talk about the feature set in a second, but to demonstrate it today, I plugged in what I used to do with my band, a Helix into it, and absolutely tear the roof off PMC Newcastle, where we're filming this right now. Due to all this being bundled into an awesome little package, it makes loading super easy, set up and set down super easy for anything you do. Like I said, playing guitar through it with a band, if you're a singer-songwriter, it's perfect. If you're a DJ, it will deliver that clear bass response you want, but also the sizzling highs at the same time. Now the feature set, which is wonderfully built into the sub down here, 3 channels. The first 2 channels have multi-inputs. You can either use an XLR or a quarter inch jack, but the cool thing is that they're all EQable. You can EQ them all, so there's treble and bass, and also a reverb on the first 2 channels. So if you're gonna plug in an acoustic guitar or a vocal microphone directly into it, you can add some reverb if you want. Whereas on channel 3, the auxiliary channel, it just has bass and treble, so you can EQ your auxiliary input, whatever fits the room that you're in, because different rooms do need to be EQ'd slightly different depending on what you're playing through it. Now speaking of that aux channel as well, you can obviously plug in anything, plug in your phone, your iPad, whatever, and play music that way. It's fully Bluetooth capable, so you can Bluetooth your phone to it and stream music through that way. And with the Bluetooth, you can also control the entire thing, all the mixer presets and whatnot, with the Bose L1 Mix app. On the 2 main channels, 1 and 2, so the channels that you'll probably plug an XLR for a microphone or a quarter inch jack for an acoustic guitar into, they actually have tone match presets built in, the same as on the S1 Pro. So straight out the box, it'll be EQ'd just lovely to fit those specific instruments. You can turn it off as well, and you can manipulate them through the L1 Mix app, or you can plug an actual tone mix into this as well, manipulate them that way, but also add extra channels and ins and outs and that kind of thing with the extra tone match. If one of the L1 Pros isn't enough for you, like it used to be in my full band with a drum kit, rock 2 either side. That also helps if you want to rock things in stereo as well. And if you want it a bit louder, you can obviously go from the 8 to the 16 and then the 32 as well.
So I guess the big question now is, do these speakers still hold out in 2023? Well, I use one of these myself and I've used it in so many different ways and different applications that the S1 Pro is probably the easiest portable speaker to set up. The great thing about this is it comes with that Bose crisp clarity that you expect from a Bose system, even in this portable speaker. It may be a lot smaller, but it still holds a lot of punch. And if you are a singer-songwriter, a solo singer, or an acoustic guitarist, then you know every time you plug this in, you're gonna have a great and consistent sound. sound. So I think, yes, these really do still hold up, and the versatility of an S1 Pro means that you can use this in so many different ways.
There is something quite special there, what you're saying about the Bose sound. It is very prominent, it's very precise, it's got a wonderful kind of high clarity and top end, it's just got a wonderful sizzle to it. It's a proper performance piece. Both these are, everything Bose touch, they've got a, it's a proper kind of performance top shelf stuff, but they don't necessarily cost. They are still expensive for what they are, because they're awesome, but they're not necessarily tens of thousands of pounds like some speakers are for gigs and whatnot. And that brings me on to the L1 Pro. Does it hold up? Hell yeah. If I was using these live, they would deliver that cloud, because how thin and how intricately designed line array systems are, whether it be this or the bigger variants, they just deliver. They're loud, they're punchy, they're clear, with the bass built in as well. Like I say, set up and tear down at a gig and load in has never been easier. They're just fantastic things. The only way from up is here, and I think these guys hold their own absolutely splendid. If you want to add anything as well to anything me and Meg said in this video, please comment down below, expand on anything that we spoke about, or add your own little comments about Bose products. Do you rock an S1 yourself? Do you rock the L1 Pro line array systems? Let us know in the comments.
Yeah, we'd love to hear from you and know what you think about these systems, but I hope you found this video useful and you've enjoyed our demonstrations on them. If you did enjoy it, make sure you hit that like button and give our channel a subscribe so you don't miss any other videos from Dagan or myself. We're also on all of the socials at Play Music Today, so you can come follow us over there too. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Meg.
And I've been Dagan.
We will catch you soon. Out your hands for me like I would for you.